I'm Mathas. I'm a 35-year-old white middle-class Australian male, and I'm here to talk to you about rap music. Obviously, there's far more qualified voices than myself to speak on this particular subject. I do feel a little bit odd about it, but ultimately, I've been on stage for over 15 years now performing hip-hop, and what's often looked at through the narrow scope of the gangster rap element is actually a cultural movement that began in the Bronx in the late 1970s. Hip-hop is African-American culture, it's Latino-American culture. It encompasses rap, DJing, breakdance, graffiti art, fashion, beatboxing, politics, and it's become one of the world's most widespread cultural phenomena. Rap is one element of a culture of many elements, and hip-hop is practiced and celebrated in almost every country in the world. Just last year, hip-hop and R&B surpassed rock for the first time to become the most listened to genres in the world. R&B popped up probably in, what, the 1940s? And it's about 45 or so years after hip-hop's inception. So it doesn't look like it's going away. I want to try and demystify the gangster rap thing just a little bit. Gangster rap came about in the mid-1980s, and it came from marginalized, oppressed people in extremely ravaged and neglected areas of the US, talking about stuff that was actually happening within their communities on ground level. Its controversiality is what made it so marketable. Most of its content actually needed to surface in a country where governments are virtually inactive in solving the problems within those communities that the music speaks on. It did become somewhat of an inflated caricature of itself, but that made money. That particular era is also referred to as the golden age of hip-hop. And the reason for that is because the level and sort of diversity of skill that was popping off in that period of time in all of the elements of hip-hop was an absolute boiling point, particularly with lyricism, particularly with lyrical skill. This is also the period of time that birthed some of the most important and powerful protest, positive protest music in the history of hip-hop, stuff like De La Soul and A Tribe Called Quest and Public Enemy, for example. Hip-hop has always been far more diverse in its messages than it's often given credit for. As an example of how important it's become in an Australian culture, in 2016, AB Original, who are an Aboriginal hip-hop duo, released a song with Dan Sultan featuring on it called January 26th. This song ended up being a contributing factor, possibly the key factor, in Triple J moving the date of their Hottest 100 away from Australia Day. Three Aboriginal artists wrote a protest song that caused a ripple in the Australian cultural fabric. And that ripple seems to be continuing. No matter how you look at that issue, it's a pretty powerful thing. In April this year, African-American hip-hop artist Kendrick Lamar became the first ever musician outside of the jazz and classical realms to win a Pulitzer Prize for music for his album Damn. Now, this album is an album filled with taboo words and concepts and street talk. It's also a succinct, virtuosic collection of songs that are little windows into African-American life. His song Humble from that album got number one in the Triple J Hottest 100 this year. Triple J is Australia's largest youth broadcaster, and the Hottest 100 is voted in by its youth listener base. So what this means is all of our kids are listening to this music. It seems the world narrative is changing somewhat. Long-lived social, political, and ethical battles are being pushed to the forefront on a world scale. The music industry is changing in turn to become more inclusive, and hip-hop is evolving to become even more diverse. There's now plenty of gay and transgender rappers. Misogyny and homophobia are becoming far less tolerated. And in Australia, women's Aboriginal and multicultural voices are becoming far more prominent in what's ultimately been a very white, male-dominated industry. Music is one of our best tools for connectivity and communication. And what rap, the most verbal of its forms, often does is it takes stories of struggle and prejudice and it puts them into a palatable, listenable, danceable form. It's quite unique in that regard because of how verbal it is. So I'd say there's always going to be stuff in it that you don't like. Try looking for the stuff that you do, because along with its great popularity, it's becoming likely one of our best vessels for distributing information. And just on a side note, there's also plenty of rappers talking about climate change at the moment. So I think what we're going to see in the future is hip-hop and its ever-expanding umbrella of diverse rap stories playing a significant role in helping to shape a more compassionate, empathetic, and ultimately less prejudicial youth. I try and create discussions about things to do with my country, its people, its politics, and my beliefs. I try and be as real with it as I can in respect to it. So I'm going to perform a little song called Stone Cold Sober, produced by my friend Kruger James, and it's a little song about my perspective on the planet and how it came to be. I've been holding off the eight now, for years watching the colors pop. Blabberguards, forever flapping their box. I'm studying their movements with a vitamin D vibrance, imagining how they'd look if they were lying lifeless. But every skerrick of my being hates hate and loathes violence, and it's an insult to insist when life is time priceless. Back in 03, my planet poked a bit of fun, turned a tragic handle, when half these frickin' camels couldn't even hold a candle to him. Gave me a dead leg, learned to let it sink in, magnetism blinking, etch a sketch on hyper in my head, trying to dry retch a mention from the earth of why he'd ended up dead. Pack of human parasites still clinging to the surface, nurtured little virus on a cell inside the vein, humming a resonance I've only found inside an 808, crushing on my planet's hum. Hand drumming on it, think I might have learned to understand it some, or something, nobody's opus, a buddy moment keep muffled its tongue. Said something, I swear it said something, crushing on my planet's hump. Cold lamping on it, think I might have learned to understand it some. And I was stone cold sober, technicolor cloak, at one with that into it till my species time to go. That's my pearly gaze, mate. Strings plucking a plasma, illustrating a universe, dwarfs whatever you're worth, little and weakly made. Either the prick of the lane, claim pick of the fetal, planet muzzled in that self-worth bubble, when a nucleus is nutrient, DNA is a maze, dubious and indescript, slowly come of age in that indefinite certain. Clapping through the curtain close, 10 years to the mark and now I first stared at his code. I saw the hills as mesh and the river a wireframe, its respiratory system huffing ways to wake and break. That memory is interlinked with smoke, a bit of heartache. Me and Nora Jones wailing top deck of the boat, with a soak pack and a Marlboro red top pocket a coat, willingly looking in limited intervals into the riff of the keynote. And I was 19, red gum, sapping out the opens, lucid, hallucinating, understanding motion, and crushing on my planet's home. Hand drumming on it, think I might have learned to understand it some, or something, nobody's opus, a buddy moment deep muffled its tongue. Said something, I swear it said something, crushing on my planet's hump. Cold lamping on it, think I might have learned to understand it some. And I was stone cold sober, technicolor cloak, at one with that into it till my species time to go. Still crushing on my planet's hump. Hand drumming on it, think I might have learned to understand it some, or something, nobody's opus, a body moment demuffled its tongue. I think, might have done, crushing on my planet's home. Cold lamping on it, think I might have learned to understand it some. And I was stone cold sober, technicolor cloak, pulsing off the orb hum, encompassing its glow, at one with that into it till my species time to go. And I'm alright with that.